volunteer stories that touch the heart from people close to us. And I'm here today to share one with you. This is the woman of the hour. She loves TV shows and movies. And what she loves most about them is the crunchy popcorn and the filling snacks that come along with it. But too much of anything makes it a rough thing, right? Right. She would spend hours after she came back from school in front of her screen watching TV shows and eating snacks all night long. However, it was her senior year. And the first thing that comes to mind is prom. And that means dressing. And who here hasn't fallen under the pressure of fitting in their forms? So she thought of ways to get rid of the snacks. She thought of how good it would feel to eat everything she could, she wanted, and gain no weight. So she goes to the bathroom. And she tries to throw off all the snacks. And it worked. She liked the idea so much that she turned it into a habit. This habit started with snacks and developed into a habit. Yes, you heard me right. She was literally throwing up everything she ate. And it just doesn't get there, stop there. It gets even worse. She starts taking laxatives and appetite suppressant pills. She became anorexic. What is anorexia, here you ask? Anorexia is a psychological and life-threatening eating disorder. It invades your body as well as your mind and thoughts. It's defined by needless and extreme weight loss and a logical fear of gaining weight and the distorted perception of self-image and body. She kept throwing up out of fear of keeping food in her body. Food now wasn't a threat. It was always linked to the idea of gaining weight, and the idea of gaining weight was unbearable for her. She thought that anorexia was there by itself. But when she really dug deep, she realized it stemmed from her lack of self-esteem. She realized that she had no love for herself, nor her body, whatsoever. And upon getting to this realization, another thought occurred to her. If she wasn't able to love herself during this tough period, when was she going? When was she going to embrace her figure if all she could see was bent out? She couldn't stand the sight of her body. She couldn't even look in the mirror. She wanted to stop. She wanted to stop because she knew that anorexia wasn't helping her anymore. She wanted to stop because no matter how much weight she lost, it wasn't enough. No matter how many times someone came to her and said, wow, you lost so much weight, it wasn't enough. No matter how many times someone told her to stop losing weight because she was hurting to the stick, it wasn't enough. She knew that this was something that couldn't last. She knew she couldn't keep throwing up all her needs for the rest of her life. She felt herself, her body, growing. Her body forgot what digesting food felt like. And she couldn't escape the bathroom anymore. She felt possessed. Sometimes she'd be like, okay, I'll keep the book this time. But the next thing she does is go to the bathroom. She was scared. She needed help. She knew she needed help. I needed help. Because she was me. Until one day, I almost collapsed. I was in a movie with my sister, and I started feeling tremor. I couldn't feel my leg, I couldn't feel my arm, I couldn't even feel my tongue. I panicked and I freaked out, and I freaked out my sister. We stopped the car. The driver got out and helped me, while my sister stood there still, crying because she didn't know what to do. I thought that this was it. So I asked her to call my parents because I wanted to see them one last time. But fortunately, before they came there, I got back. And I thought it would be best if they didn't know. So I lied to them. But I had to tell her the truth. And if you know me, you know that my sister is the closest person to me. She's my favorite person on this planet. But after I told her, something changed. When I confronted her, she started yelling. She got really mad. She started yelling. She started crying while yelling. She tried to tell my parents. And she even told me that she wouldn't let me go to university abroad because she was afraid that the next time I collapsed, there would be no one there to save me. We stopped talking for a very long, hard week. I almost lost her. That collapse was my wake-up call. That collapse was a turning point. That day I knew I couldn't go on in this anymore. Once I knew the effect it had on other people, once I saw how much my parents were hurting, once I noticed that my dad started taking his notes because he couldn't sleep anymore because of what I was doing to myself, I knew I had to put an end to this. I stopped throwing up. But that didn't mean that I started loving myself. I need an intangible, because this came from somewhere in here. I need to make sure I wasn't going to lose my sister. More importantly, I needed to make sure I wasn't going to lose myself. It's very difficult to stand here and say this bluntly in front of 100 people, but sometimes you have to get good things out of bad things. I'll share with you my recovery tips, and I'll keep them as general as possible because every inch of you matters. I want this speech to be the start of every recovery. Because if someone here hates their fingertips, they're here. I'll tell you some of the things I did to get over this. Maybe they help you, maybe they help someone you know. Or at least I will be here. Usually we put our educators under the spotlight. But that's wrong. I did this and I got it. You are more than a body. You are your decisions, you are your kind deeds, you are your actions. Embrace your flaws, embrace your mistakes, embrace the mistakes you haven't even made yet, because you're human, you're not perfect, and you make mistakes. Try looking at yourself in a different light. Look at who you are on the inside, not who you are on the outside. Stop focusing on the negatives and start focusing more on the positives. For example, if you're insecure about fitting in, stop freaking out about meeting new people and concentrate more on your closest circle. It's not just about you. It's about you and it's about the people who love you. If you're hurting yourself, you're hurting them too. Anorexia is just as bad as cutting. Hurting yourself, hating yourself, is just as bad as cutting. If you're not dying, you're wasting your life hating yourself. Know that there are people around you who love you, who care about you, and who want you to help. Seek help. Seek help because seeking help is not wrong. It's not something you should be ashamed of. We live in a society where going to a psychiatrist automatically builds a first impression. But it doesn't have to be a psychiatrist. It could be a family member, it could be a friend, it could be a stranger even. Just talk about it. Talk about it because talking about it helps. It helps you see things clearer. It helps you put your thoughts into words. It helps you realize that there are other people out there just like you. Also, it doesn't have to be by talking about it. It could be by doing the things that you love. You can find love and care in anything around you. Realize that your body is your temple. Your body is the vehicle that is running you this far into this life. It's what you're experiencing life with. It has survived all these years and because the red one. And I guess everyone here is looking for happiness. So how can you be happy if your body is not happy? Stop trying to win people's approval. At some point in my life, I only looked at myself through people's eyes. It got to a point where I'd be talking to someone, and all I could think of is that this person is fighting the urge to laugh at my fat jokes, even though I didn't have any. Is that this person is questioning why they're talking to me, because I'm so fat. If someone came up to me and said that they love me, I'd be like, oh my god, someone loves me even though I'm fat. But no, don't be like that. Be like, why wouldn't they? Because you're awesome. And you are awesome, and don't let anyone convince you otherwise. However, know that you won't find chemistry with everyone. But that only means that you're charismatic and you stand out. Remember the good things in your life. Remember the good people in your life. Remember the warm hug your mom gave you on a bad day, or the endorphin boost got after a nice workout. Go tell a friend you love them, and hear them say they love you back. Let yourself know and remind yourself that you love.